Tis the season for some Native American Indian stories, am I right? Today, we're talking about some nations from North America, specifically the Iroquois creation story. Now, before we begin, quick disclaimer. We good? Good. Let's go. Now, unlike a lot of creation stories, this one starts when the Earth is already formed. It's always sort of existed. The sky was home to superior beings, who I will refer to as spirits for the rest of the video. And among them, the Great Spirit ruled over all. Now, the Great Spirit's daughter had become pregnant without him knowing. When the Great Spirit found out about this, he was not happy, and he went down to Earth. Now, a lot of northeastern nations thought of the Earth as a giant floating turtle, so they called it Turtle Island. The Great Spirit went down to Turtle Island and uprooted a tree so he could throw his daughter into the hole. The turtle felt the tree get uprooted, and he threw some mud up there so that when the daughter landed, she wouldn't be killed by his hard shell. The problem is, he didn't realize she landed, so he kept piling mud up there. Eventually, the daughter gave birth, but because of the mud flow, she eventually got encased. She's a spirit, so she didn't die. Instead, she became Mother Earth, who cared for and loved her daughter all her life. The daughter of Mother Earth was extremely beautiful, and many spirits went down to Earth in human form to propose to her. The spirits went to Mother Earth to get approval, but she refused every single one of them. She refused everyone until a middle-aged man of a dignified appearance came to her. He was a hunter who owned a bow and quiver, and he asked Mother Earth if he could have her daughter's hand in marriage. She allowed this when he paid the price for her daughter, and when he did, the two were happily married. As time went on, she noticed the man never laid with her daughter in the house. He only put his arrows at his wife's side while she slept, and he'd take them with him the next day when he left. Eventually, the hunting spirit had to leave though, and around the same time he left, the Earth Mother saw that her daughter was pregnant. She couldn't figure out by who though, since the hunter disappeared. The daughter became pregnant with twins, and the twins spoke to each other in the womb. One said, "We should leave through our mother's side." The other one said, "No, leaving through her side will kill her. We must leave the normal way." The twin who talked first pretended to agree, and he even let his brother be born first. When his brother was out of the womb, though, the twin forced himself through his mother's side, killing her in childbirth. Because of the death of their mother, the twins were raised by their grandmother, Mother Earth. She named the firstborn Te'eron Gaiawago. I'm very sorry if I mispronounced that. Which means holder of heaven, and she named the secondborn son Tawiskeron. Very sorry if I mispronounced that. Which means flinty rock. He got that name because when he was born, he was already covered in flint rock. The two boys grew up to be hunters using bows and arrows. Tawiskeron was a master, and he earned a reputation of being the best hunter in all the land. Te'eron Gaiawago was not so lucky, and he struggled with hunting for a long time. To add insult to injury, Tawiskeron made fun of his brother alongside Grandmother Earth. You know, it's normal for siblings to take jabs at each other, but it's gotta really hurt when your grandma joins in. One day, while Te'eron Gaiawago was out walking, he saw a vision appear before him, and he heard a voice say, "My son, I have seen your distress. You are unhappy with your skills and treatment by your brother and grandmother. I will now comfort you. I am your father, and I will give you these." The vision of his father held out a hand, and he grabbed an ear of maize, although you probably know it as corn, out of it. The father said, "Plant it and tend to it. It will yield you support independent of hunting. I am the great turtle which supports the earth you move on. Your brother's ill treatment of you will increase, but bear with it." He showed his son how to plant corn before vanishing. Te'eron Gaiawago went home and planted the corn. Te'eron Gaiawago tended to the crops as his father instructed. He cleared away the grass and weeds, and eventually sprouts formed and began flourishing. While he was busy caring for the corn, though, Te'eron Gaiawago didn't realize what his brother was doing. Tawiskeron had gone all over the forest and captured every animal he could, the deer, the elk, and many other harmless creatures. He trapped them inside a cave for his own nefarious purposes. Te'eron Gaiawago tried following his brother to the cave, but Tawiskeron was incredibly nimble and always evaded his brother. Te'eron Gaiawago got an idea. While following his brother, he noticed Tawiskeron never looked up to the trees or the sky. Te'eron Gaiawago followed his brother, but this time he stayed to the trees. And sure enough, Tawiskeron never looked up, and he led him right to the cave. Terhan Gayawaga waited for his brother to leave, and when he was gone, he made his move. He went inside the cave and freed all the animals so they could return to the forest. Terhan Gayawaga went to various villages all over the map, and the people were extremely happy to see the animals back in the wild. Terhan Gayawaga knew he did the right thing, and was happy his people were happy. When Tawiskeron returned to the cave, he was outraged to see the animals were set free, and he knew exactly who did it. Tawiskeron was crafty, though, and he knew he couldn't exact revenge right away. Instead, he went to meditate and plan for a time in the future to do so. For now, Tawiskeron would simply infect humans with evilness and wickedry. He did this because he knew his brother would hate that more than anything. Terhan Gayawaga knew his brother was infecting people with evilness, and while at first he wanted to do something, he just remembered what his father said. His poor treatment of you will increase, but just bear with it. Later on, the two brothers had a conversation that went something like this. Hey brother, what is your weakness? Oh, reeds from the lake, and lake foam, something like that. What about you? Flint rocks. Huh, pretty neat. Another time, Terhan Gayawaga was walking home from hunting when he heard someone in the woods singing. And what's really weird is that they mentioned his dead mother. He ran to find the source of the singing, and he only found the tracks of a fawn. The baby deer kind, not the Roman satyr. He followed these tracks while shouting, "Who is the one who mentions my deceased mother's name?" This fawn was fast and constantly ahead of him until autumn when it dropped its horns. When the fawn dropped his horns, Terhan Gayawaga fixed them to a tree, and this exact process happened for 7 years. Now that's some determination for you. The fawn was now a buck, and Terhan Gayawaga finally caught it. When he caught it, the buck said, "Please spare me, I'll give you useful information." Terhan Gayawaga promised he would spare the buck, and it said, "The whole reason I subjected you to this chase was to give you information. But I did it so you could prove you were determined enough. You must know, your brother is the reason your mother is dead. He had an evil, wicked heart when he was an infant, and his malice only grows with his stature. He now plans to commit an evil act against you. Therefore, be on your guard, and as soon as he attacks you, you must defend yourself." Terhan Gayawaga took heed of the buck's advice, and on his way home, he took the horns that had fallen from the fawn, as well as some flint for the battle with his brother. And sure enough, when Terhan Gayawaga arrived at home, he was attacked by Tawiskeron. Tawiskeron armed himself with reeds from the lake, but they had no effect on Terhan Gayawaga. The two brothers fought for days, all over the land on the turtle's back. Every village they passed picked up the different tones of their fight, and that's why different languages are spoken by people today. The battle was long and bloody, but eventually Tawiskeron was killed by his brother, and Terhan Gayawaga stood victorious. And that's the Iroquois creation story. Not only is it a creation story, though, if you look closely, you can pick out details that describe Iroquois culture. Some are more noticeable than others, like the origins of farming, but it also shows how matrilineal the society can be, with the children living with their grandmother, and their father being more of a distant but still present figure. It also explains why jerks exist, because evil did not vanish with Tawiskeron's death. The people he already infected were still living, and they passed their evil onto their own children. A lot of Iroquois history and culture revolves around the idea of maintaining balance, and it all stems from this story with Terhan Gayawaga's interactions with his brother. Apologies for any mispronunciations in this video. I tried to find some guides online, but they're just so difficult to find. I couldn't even find any in my own book about the Iroquois. But other than that, I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching, leave a like if you enjoyed, and subscribe if you want to see more. I have a Twitter and Discord where I post memes, so you can go follow those if you want. And until next time, have a good one.